ask you. Guys, let's give it up for Chilli, everybody!
Hey, everyone. It looks like you're all having fun tonight. Some of these comedians are pretty good, right? A big round of applause so far. Yeah, I wish things were going really good for me, but that's not the case. A few things. I'm Canadian. Kind of going through a midlife crisis. You know, I'm trying to find like some new careers or jobs I can do. So what I've been doing is talking with my friends, and they're giving me advice in terms of like what kind of job I can get, right? So I was talking with my buddy Jimmy San Andreas. He's a geophysical engineer. Jimmy San Andreas. He's got his faults, let me tell you. No, it's true. It's true. Anyway, I said, well, can you get me a job? He says, yeah, I can get you a job at a quarry. And you know what a quarry is? That's where you're like banging, you know, like granite and quartz all day long, right? So I started at that job, and I was there for a couple of days. I enjoyed it a lot, but they fired me after a couple of days. They said I was stoned. I don't know. And man, that really busted me up too. And it put me between a rock and a hard place because my buddy Jimmy San Andreas, you know, recommended this. So I went back to Jimmy and I said, you know, Jimmy, you know, you're a bit shifty with this job, you know, recommendation. Do you have any others? And he said, yeah, actually I do. I have this, you can join this company. And what they do is they build cylindrical holes into the ground for the purpose of extracting water and bring it to the surface, right? So it's used on farms and things like that. And I said to him, I said, well, I think this might be something I can do. And so, sure enough, I started doing this work, and I was in charge of these motors, right, that were to extract, like, to bring the water to the surface, and I was getting pumped up about working with these devices, you know, but after a couple of days, I just thought, these motors suck, you know, Unfortunately, you know, and I got fired from that job after a couple of days too. And that was tough too because they didn't even pay me. Man, I got the shaft on that one, I'm telling you. And anyway, that was a boring job. I gotta tell you, that was a boring job. So I went back to Jimmy San Andreas. I said, Jimmy, you're shaky, man. Like, what's going on? He says, I got another one for you. It's working for a gentleman that builds roofs for houses, right? And I said, okay, that sounds good. So I met the guy, and he said, and I think he was a stand-up comedian, because he said, hey, can I trust you? And I said, yes, you can trust me. He said, no, can I trust you? And I said, yes. He said, can I trust you? And I said, yes again. I think he maybe just talks in threes. So anyway, I got the job, I rejoiced, and I tell you, I really liked that job, but after a couple of days, I got fired again. He said he just thought the work was over my head. So that was kind of tough. So then I thought, I'm going to do this on my own. I'm going to go on my own. So I went to a conference in Las Vegas, and it's like a gardener's conference, and because I thought maybe I'd become a gardener, right? So I'm in Las Vegas at this gardener's conference, and of course, their gambling starts, right? Poker and they don't gamble with chips. They gamble with, you know, the kind of stuff that they sell at gardening shops, right? And I did really well. Well, put it this way, you know, I have enough shrubbery to completely enclose my yard. And they told me, they thought I was hedging my bets. I don't know. But So anyway, but I didn't last with that either. And the funny thing is, I have a friend. His name is Jimmy Casket. And he works, yeah, it's his name. It's his real name. Scout's honor, whatever hand it is. So Jimmy Casket, he works at a funeral home. So he's a mortician, right? And so he does his work, but he also does telekinesis. And it turns out he got fired from his job because they said he was raising the dead. So anyway, a couple more things. Inflation's going on. I like to buy these candies. They're 1 cent per candy, and they've doubled the price recently. I'm thinking of going down to that company and giving them my 2 cents worth, let me tell you. But the last thing I've observed as well is, though, do you notice this? That people are buying books about reincarnation like there's no tomorrow. Right? Hey, thanks again. I'm Chilli. Sorry.